Oh, hey, you want to remain friends with my narcissistic ex? I understand. Yep, I get it. And by the way, we're no longer friends. And if you're a family member, we're no longer talking. We're not on good terms. If you can listen to that smear campaign and sit there and be comfortable with it, we were never friends and we were never family. We're done.
If your partner is a narcissist, they don't really know you. This is because they project all of their inner insecurities and all of their terrible actions onto you. I mean, they're like that, so they have to assume that everybody else is like that, right? And so your innate kindness and your compassion, they don't trust it. I mean, they're very paranoid people. And because they cannot stand when you're happy, because if you're happy and they're unhappy, it's unfair in their minds, right? So they will criticize you. They will try to abuse you emotionally and psychologically, and they'll call you names or they'll dismiss you or they will ignore you, right? I mean, really, can you even have a conversation with them other than the weather, the dog, and then maybe, I don't know, what's for dinner? You are with somebody who doesn't even know you because they don't even know who they are.
I'm gonna say it depends. And what it depends on is like how recent is the lie? Is it a lie that I've been telling since I was little? You know, because a lie that I've been telling since I was a kid, I'm 35 years old now, so that lie I believe. Like I've told that lie so many times since I was 7, 8 years old that I started to believe it myself. So it's my truth now. Even if it is a lie, it's my truth, if you understand what I'm saying. So a long distance lie like that, yes, we actually believe it, so we can tell it with truthful it, like with truth and honesty behind it. But something that just like off the tip of our tongues, hell no, we know that is some complete BS. Like if you catch us in a bold-faced lie where you have proof, we know that is not true. We know that anything in our brains and that comes out of our mouth, we know is some bullshit. We know that. But if we talk enough, you might start to believe it's a lie. That's where the gaslighting and word salad come in. So being too nice to a narcissist will get you taken advantage of and manipulated to the umpteenth power. I know a lot of times, like the empath person or whatever, if you consider yourself an empath, people look at empaths as like inherently nice, caring people that can't be mean for some reason. So narcissists know your nature and they know that you are inherently nice and you won't do anything to them. So they will take advantage of that. Like you catch a narcissist cheating, it's like, hey, look, I know you're not the type of person to put me on blast because they would embarrass both of us and it would ruin my reputation and ruin my ability to take care of the family and stuff like that. So look, just keep this between us. I know you're not that type of person to do that to somebody. Stop sparing these motherfuckers' feelings because I can 100% attest to the fact that they will not spare yours. It's okay to be mean sometimes. Your niceness will be used against you like a weapon.